never been gobbled. Drove the man to the grave. Where the men for a world with a Neanderthal girl. And that's how he raised him to the grave.
Oh, I'm going to Barbados. I'll tell you one. Right, we've got one from Barbados. Why am I crouching? Let's lower this down a bit. Oh! Right, that puts me right in the picture. I've done that well, didn't I? Right, Barbados. We've got Stallion. Shall I get a bit deeper? Stallion. Amazing. We've got Stallion there. Stallion Stout. Finest quality. Quality. It's a tiny, whiny, weeny, whiny, tiny one. 275 milliliters. Not sure the relevance of 275. Pardon me. Bit bigger than that. What is it? 568 would be third. 568. That'd be 284. 284 would be half a pint, so it's just short of half a pint. What's it say on the back? Brewed and bottled. Banks. This is the Banks in Jamaica. Banks is something. Brewery. Barbados Brewery Limited. Christchurch, Barbados, West Indies. Right, so it's all good. It says drink responsibly, drink aware, drink this, drink that. It looks like it could be a milk stout because it says malted barley and milk ingredients. Now, I'll tell you a quick thing about the milk stouts while I open it. You've got sugar in milk called lactose and yeast that brews up, that ferments, I should say. Oh, I keep saying brews. Brewing and fermenting are different things. And I'm kind of kick myself every time I say it. I kind of refer to fermenting as brewing. And they're completely different. But anyway, I do digress. There's a very lovely pretty crown there with a little red horse on him. Not sure the significance of that. Let me know if you know. Because that's what this is about, I think. I could read up galore on these things, but I use what's in here, what I already know. Sometimes I read up, but a lot of it I kind of use what's in there and then let you guys talk to me and talk with me, you know. Oh, it smells lovely. It smells absolutely gorgeous. Now, lactose. Yeah, lactose, the yeast that ferment beer up and everything else, and that's lively. Beer and the sugars in beer and everything else, or the barley sugars, barley, wheat, and whatever else. But mainly in beer, you're kind of mainly talking barley, and you've got alpha and beta amylase, crack all them big molecules up into shorter, glucose and whatever, sucrose, or whatever, the shorter molecules, the little sweet. Not fructose, what are you talking? There's all sorts of sugars, let's put it that way. And yeast ferments all sorts of sugars, but lactose has a bit of trouble with. So what ends up happening is any milk sugars in there, they get left alone more or less, and they stay sweet right up to the end. And that's what the milk stouts do. Now, really, really dark. Dark, almost black, but beautiful, beautiful, really beautiful, sort of red, burgundy, almost purple, but a red, burgundy little glint in there, just coming through, but almost black. But that's really rosy and lovely. Right, 12, as you can see, the head is kind of quite dark, dark tan in it. Big, kind of condensed milk almost, sweetness in there. That condensed milk, sugary, lactosey sort of smell, taste. You've got toasty notes in the background. Hints of fig roll. No, little fig roll things. Little biscuits. Hints of that as well. But it smells lovely. It really smells lovely. It doesn't smell, you know, over kind of complex or anything like that. But it smells lovely. It smells rich, nutritious and delicious. It smells like it puts lead in your pencil, if you know what I mean. Now, for a dyslexic like me, my pencil's all over the place. And, you know, I've got no one to write to. But anyone that don't know what I'm on about, you're lost, completely lost. But there you go. I'm, you know, too subtle for my own good. Right, let's get on with it. Come on, drink. Let's go. Oh, fucking hell. Oh. That is... do forgive me. I'm going to swear. Turn your volume down if, you know, if you're against it or anything. But it's the only way. Sometimes we've got a language that's full of words and we kind of cut a lot of them off. And sometimes, fair dues, you know, there's certain words in the English language that are a bit sharp, you know, and a bit nasty. And to anyone's ears, you know, no matter how broad-minded you are, sometimes there's certain words that are just nasty. But that I've got to describe that. They're fucking awesome. Sorry. Okay, you can click, put your volume back up again. Right, sorry. But that is cool. That is, I nearly said it again then. Jesus, right. Let's get in here. Let's sort of describe this if I can. This is complex as well. And it's massive. And I think I got this quite cheap. I can't remember where. Maybe B&M or something like that. But, let's go. Right, let's get the boisterous, unsubtle ones out of the way first. Super malt, if you've ever tried that, it's kind of like, it's pretty much the wort that you get. This what it's kind of flavour like, concentrated down. It's a bit like that, like the wort you get, like the barley sugars and everything concentrated down. It's like that, a little bit of toast in there, a little bit of chocolate and a little bit of coffee. Small amounts, but big, malt, you know, that's the unsubtle ones, and they're beautiful, they are beautiful, absolutely beautiful. Now the subtle ones, you've got, pardon me, little floral notes, tiny little floral notes, quite big, Christmas pudding, currants, things like that in there. Certainly currants. You got a little bit of mince pies, currants, Christmas pudding. You could have this with Christmas dinner, with Christmas dinner. But you could have this with the kind of mince pie part of it and everything else. Mince pies and custard and everything else. And then you go, wee, get one of them down with it. Certainly could. This is a really, really lovely beer. Rich and delicious. I don't mean to sound misogynistic, but this is one the ladies could have as well because it's sweet and lovely. Yes, I know there's ladies that like the nasty, like that. But, you know, there's... I think a lady's palate is slightly different to ours. It likes to be, on the whole, it likes to be kind of massaged and gently smoothed and things. It doesn't like to be attacked with harsh hops, fruity maybe, certainly sweety sort of hops in it. This is just my opinion and but I kind of got my ear to the ground with people and that, and people say, well, my missus likes the wheat beers and she likes the fruity beers and she likes the sweet beers and things like that. And I hear it so often that my ear to the ground kind of tells me sometimes a little bit more than people like Molson Coors with their millions of pounds and years of kind of of research into beers like anime, and it goes shoom, down the drain within half a year because people ain't buying it. Because they go, the bloody hell do you think we are? Wait, let's get this down. Jeez, oh, do you know what? That's the sad part of that. If there is any sadness in that, it's 5%, so it's kind of sessionable. Should be in a bigger bottle. If there is any sadness in that, it's that it's in such a tiny bottle. But then again, I don't think I paid a lot for it. I'm hoping that I've got it on one of my receipts here. I don't think so. I'm sure I didn't have one that I knocked on the floor a minute ago. But that is beautiful. That is bloody beautiful. Have a look in B&M's because I've got a few beers. I can't remember where exactly I bought that, but either Tesco's or B&M's, quite possibly. I might have got it somewhere else on me little journeys. But that is excellent. Bloody, bloody excellent, that is. Yeah, that is fantastic. That's going in my little list of bloody good beers. My little recommendation beers. I've got quite a few in there. Let me know if I've kind of said that any beers, oh, this is wonderful. And like, there are certain beers that I get. I know I'm stretching it on again, my length of my bloody reviews. Sorry. But there are certain beers that I get, that I taste, that people, you know, you get the connoisseurs and the beer experts and things like that. I'm not knocking anyone, but you get people, for an example, Orville beer, you know, Belgian beer and everything else, and you know, all that jazz and all this, you know. Sometimes people go, Travis, way brilliant. And you know, Ryan High School, yeah, it's gotta be a great beer. Ain't always the case. And so you got something like Orville. I wish I could fly, you know. It was distinctly average, you know. It wasn't for me, it wasn't special. And people said, well, maybe it was the bottle you had. And a lot of people really enjoyed it. Fair dues. One thing about craft beer or real ales or, you know, proper beer fans, there's no distinct kind of label on what we are, isn't it? But quality beer, really. I kind of like craft beer because it's beer that's crafted. Real ales to do with live yeast and things like that. But it's beer that's crafted. And, you know, It's a beauty, thing of beauty. And it's like art, you know. Where was I? My brain's gone. And this bit's gone a wisp. But, you know, the thing is that we think for ourselves. If you have gone away from the, indoctrination corporations beers, if you've gone away from the McLagers, the Popsy McLagers, then you've kind of started thinking for yourselves and you're going, right, let's try a few different beers out every week or something like that. And you're going, right, I'm not going to get settled in and some Fosters and all that being. It's because someone with a muscle drinks it and someone on the beach playing volleyball with their knockers hanging out drinks it. You've kind of gone, it's not for me. I think for myself. I'm a shepherd, not a sheep, you know. Anyway. I do digress, but you get these sort of beers known by no one, really. I don't think a lot of people will know that. Maybe in the kind of, maybe the West Indian community or something might know a bit more about it, but then they'll probably be on the, what's the one by Red Stripe? I can't think of the name of it. God, blimey. I think there'll certainly be on different beers and maybe a bit of Guinness and can't think of the name of that one. Something Dragon, is it? Dragon, Red Dragon or something. But I think that one won't show up much on the old radar. But you got to try it. It's bloody beautiful. Cheers, everyone. Bottoms up. God, that is good. With a man for a world with a new